For my own part, I have never had a thought which I could not set down in words with even more distinctness than that which I conceived it. There is, however, a class of fancies of exquisite delicacy which are not thoughts, and to which as yet I have found it absolutely impossible to adapt to language. These fancies arise in the soul, alas, how rarely, only at epochs of most intense tranquility, when the bodily and mental health are in perfection, and at those mere points of time where the confines of the waking world blend with the world of dreams. And so I captured this fancy, where all that we see or seem is but a dream within a